Hello, welcome back to my series, Fit Before 50. This is episode 5, Why Walking. So one thing I wanted to clarify, I've been following my episodes. In the episode I mentioned, in the episode 2, I was talking about why I started doing HIIT. I had been exercising and I was doing a lot of yoga and walking. And I wasn't seeing gains as far as losing weight and losing inches doing those exercises. By no means am I trying to say that that type of exercise is not effective. Yoga and walking is also extremely effective. If you're trying to do it for weight loss, any exercise program you get into, you still have to monitor what you put in your body. So it doesn't matter if you might lose a little bit of weight without changing your routine too much as far as what you're consuming, but if you don't make any significant changes in that arena, you're really not gonna see the results. So I didn't want it to sound like it was those types of exercise weren't beneficial, they are. So back to walking and why you want to walk. If you're looking to start getting into a fitness routine and you haven't figured out where to start, walking is one of the easiest and most cost-effective things you can do. And because with walking, you can simply walk in your neighborhood. You can walk at the mall. I mean, there's just unlimited availability of where you can do your walking exercises. Treadmill, obviously, number one, if you have one in your house or the gym. And you can slowly build up to longer distances if that's what you're trying to do. I mean, I don't want you to feel like you've got to have an end in mind right away to get going. Keep it very simple. If it's just, I want to walk around the block today. Maybe I'll walk around 2 tomorrow. Maybe by the end of the week, I'll go a mile. Make them little tiny milestones and make them attainable goals. Don't make it too crazy. Because if you're not really doing any exercise and this is where you're starting, you still have to build up a level of strength and endurance to do it. Another way to get into a walking routine is to join a cause. For example, there's so many walks that are raising awareness for breast cancer, all these different types of functions, autism. That's a really good way to get your body prepared because you usually have to kind of train for some of those walks. My friend and I did a 3-day walk this last summer. It was 20 miles a day. 60 miles total, and that was our first walk. So granted, I wouldn't recommend making that your first walk because it's pretty intense, but we enjoyed ourselves so much and there was so much reward that goes beyond obviously taking part in the cause and raising awareness. I believe the average steps we did per day was about 52,000 steps, and then the last day we did 30,000 steps. And just seeing those numbers, you're like, wow, I can't believe that I'm actually able to do this. No, not saying that you should do a 3-day walk right away, but maybe a shorter walk. And you still have to work up to those miles. So you still want to practice. It gives you a period of time and an end in mind. Maybe you're going to do a walk in the fall and you want to make sure that you can handle and your endurance is there. You can start walking now. Keep track. Get a partner. I mean, I was so happy to have a partner to do this walk with me. I mean, it was just so much more motivating to have her to train with. So if you can buddy up, even better. But let's talk about some more health benefits about yoga, because otherwise I'm going to keep rambling on. Or not yoga, walking, sorry. So one of the benefits of walking and why I like it so much is because it lowers blood pressure. I had a bout of blood pressure issues a few years ago, and I really think that being in a more consistent exercise routine that included walking, it really helped regulate that blood pressure, and I'm not necessarily required to take any medication. I'm always on the cusp a little bit. It's a hereditary thing too, so I have to keep an eye on it, but definitely helps keep that blood pressure down as well as your cholesterol too. It also lowers your fasting sugar. So if you're at risk for diabetes, and you want to keep those blood glucose levels low, walking is a great way to do that. So I highly recommend walking for those reasons. This is a big one for me. Better memory and cognitive function. I can honestly say that I struggle with this always. And I do have Alzheimer's. It runs in my family. So it's always in the back of my mind when I start forgetting things. Like, oh God, is this the onset? Like, do I need to be worried about this? I can honestly say that since I've been incorporating more exercise into my routine the last few years, I'm much better in that area, I feel. I don't know, maybe people around me think otherwise, but forgetfulness is one of those things that I'm always like, really nervous about because it's that I'm always thinking it's leading on to something else. So knowing that I'm improving my cognitive function is huge, and I think it's another great benefit to walking as a form of exercise. Also, it helps lower your stress. Stress is the devil. Stress will cause havoc on our bodies in so many more ways than you realize. It ages us. It just degenerates our organs, power to cleanse our bodies more. Stress keeps us up at night. I mean, it causes us to stress out and eat foods that are bad for us, maybe drink more than we should. I can go on and on. So if you're looking for something that's going to really help improve stress and or reduce stress and improve your mood, walking might be one of those things you should try. So I hope you found these tips useful. Obviously, you can find a lot more of them on the internet as I did. I just want to speak from what my experience is. I will see you on the next episode, and thanks for watching.